अस्सलाम वालेकुम। एज आई सेड और एज आई प्रॉमिस टू यू ऑल ऑफ यू दैट आई विल मेक वीडियोस रिलेटेड टू कॉकटेल म्यूटेशन एंड द स्टार्टिंग वुड बी फ्रॉम रेयर म्यूटेशन ऑफ कॉकटेल्स। आई एम ऑल्सो हैविंग माई फोन विद मी, सो इफ आई डू मिक्स अप समथिंग आई कैन चेक इट आउट। मोर ओवर आई एम वेरी एक्साइटेड डूइंग इट एंड इट इज मोर डिफिकल्ट टू डू रादर देन मेकिंग अदर वीडियोज बिकॉज यू हैव टू स्पीक आउट अबाउट द थिंग्स दैट जनरली यू कैन से रॉन्गली बट हेयर यू हैव टू टॉक इट इन अ प्रॉपर मैनर एंड यू नीड वैन वाइल यू आर रिकॉर्डिंग इट यू हैव टू बी मोर एक्यूरेट एंड यू कैन गेट मिक्स अप इवन गेटिंग ओवर एक्साइटेड। सो इफ आई वुड डू सम फंबल्स प्लीज फॉर गिव मी बिकॉज इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी टू मेक सच काइंड ऑफ वीडियोज बट आई एम ट्राइंग माई बेस्ट। I am having information, I am reading emeralds, but that doesn't mean that I can say out everything in specially, you can say, English language. I do also get excited while making a Urdu video, but still English video is a bit more tough than making an Urdu video. So let's move toward the video. Emerald is the 13th established mutation and it is abbreviated as EM or O. Why it is abbreviated as O also? Because it is also known as olive or suffused silver or suffused yellow or spangle or dilute. So if somebody writes it as emerald olive or olive emerald, then it means the same thing and repeating the same name twice. So there is no use of repeating the word same. If you say it emerald, then it means same. If you just say it olive, then it means same. Rather than mentioning the both name, you should be focusing on just one, because few people want to play smart by combining the name and trying to form another mutation. So as it is a 13 mutation, it was first appeared in Norma and John Ludwig Avery in US, and they consulted Marge Mason for this purpose to check out what is the name of this, and Marge Mason named it as emerald. So it is more commonly known as emerald for that reason. And emeralds are very hard to describe, and even in starting I do mix up emeralds and DS with normal birds, but now as I started breeding it from 2016, the first pair was a split pair and I saw splits and emerald growing together, so I got more identification and it is more easy for me to identify. And dominant silver also started breeding from 2017, so it is bit more easy for me to identify. Even still I do mix up some of the bird, especially if they are in pied or they are in darker tone. I will try to share some of my birds pictures within the video or at the end of the video, where you can see some of my emeralds and different colors and their different patterns. So let's start this video again. As I said, emeralds are very hard to describe, so describing it may take some doing. So as cockatails do not have gray color in green color in them, gray is the color of the wild bird, green color in them. So how this greenish look do come in it? The first thing that causes is the dark pigments or melanin is greatly reduced, giving an overall pale tan gray. And green illusion is caused because of yellow is mixed with this thing and this reduced gray, and it causes an illusion of green. You can say if it is more intense, then it can look like a drab olive color. Drab olive color, hope you are you are knowing about that color, that how it looks like. Further, there are many common traits of dominant silver and emerald. That's why it is said that do not pair up these two birds, because you won't end up having more common traits birds and you won't be able to identify them visually. So it is better to keep them separately. So what are the common traits between them? The common trait between them is dark beak and dark feet. Dark beak and dark feet are not just only found in emeralds and DS, but also found in common gray, white face charcoal and pearls. So keep that in mind, that every dark feet and dark beak bird doesn't mean that it is a DS or it is an emerald. Moreover, it has dark edges like a DS bird, and it can also have spangle. I will share some of my emeralds that will also help you to identify. I have a spangle white face emerald with me, which you can check out. But that spangle bird looks like more like a DS rather than looking like an emerald. So how can you check that the bird you are having is an emerald or DS? As emerald, sorry, I forgot to mention, as emerald is a recessive bird, so emerald is either both of the birds to be visual, or two or both of the bird to be split, or one of the bird to be visual and other bird to be split. So then you can produce the emerald, and DS needs only one. When you pair up a bird, you are not knowing either it is emerald or DS with a normal gray of pure line, then the result would be telling you that what you have. A dominant silver will produce dominant silver in the clutch, and an emerald will produce just splits. But sometime if you are producing single factor dominant silver, then they may look like common gray or white face charcoal, so you may need to get them molted, especially if they are males, they will tell you after the first molt. But if they are females, I bet sometimes even I get confused of the females. I got confused about a female thinking it as a common gray, but to my you can say it was very shocking for me, or it was very astonishing for me that I was not breeding that bird because I thought it is a gray and I should wait for it. Rather, I started pairing more of the dominant silver that were clearly dominant silver. When I paired that up with a common gray male that came out of dominant silver in first clutch, that gave me dominant silver. So then I checked that bird thoroughly. It was of more than 2 years of age, and still I mixed it up. So when I thoroughly check after that breed results, in second breed they also gave me the dominant silver. So I started checking about the female. The female was having bit different color than the normal gray. That made me identify that it is a dominant silver. So as I told, for emerald you need either both splits, both visual, or one visual and one split to produce it. Olive green color is basically present over all of the you can say washout color is present on the back of the body or overall body of the bird. That is depending upon different birds. Different birds who have different kind of olive washout over them, and grayish tan. That sorry, emeralds can vary from grayish tan to light yellow gray color. This is the variation. As I will share some of my emeralds, you will come to know that there are different colors. Some pictures may not be 100% clear, but they will give you some kind of image, and I will try my best to share as many as it would be possible for me. I also keeping that eye on time because I do not want to make it a very long video, because in long video it gets more difficult for me to edit, and it gets difficult for people to understand it. So emeralds are also known as very good breeders, like common gray cockatails, and I bet I have got many many good results from emeralds. Rather than albinos or lutinos or even other mutations, I have got very good results from emeralds and DS. So they are very good breeders. So you should also do not think of it that they may not be good breeders. And the babies may have, you can say, tips will look like pale tan flight feathers. Tip of the flight feathers would be pale tan or yellowish gray tint in them. That will help you to identify it from a young age. Both males and female will look alike in young age, but males will molt off even if they have spangle pattern or grayish tone. They will molt off to a color. I will share an adult bird with you so you can see it. But some of the males do retain some kind of tan gray spots in them. That helps them to understand, because emeralds have different mutation. I will make a separate video on it because I do not want to make this video lengthy, and I will do tell about the some of the pairing results, and then there would be questions from your side about the pairing, and I would be telling you about the results. Moreover, as emeralds are not very well known, why, what is the reason, or they are not found in that much big quantity, what is the reason behind it? The reason behind it is that emeralds do have much more males than the females in the production. So let me just give you a figure. If you have 15 birds in a season, then there are more chances of 10 males and 15 sorry 5 females that will end up having only 5 pairs with you, and you cannot breed more birds. So less birds for breeding, that means less birds in future too. Sorry, I got tired because it is Ramzan and my throat is not properly lubricated, so I get tired or I feel bit more pain while speaking, and I am speaking very loud just to make a clear video. So this thing help us to understand why there are less emeralds available. Not it is just because people don't like it, but it is because there are much more males than the females available. So which birds are there with whom we should not pair up emeralds? So emeralds should not be paired up with melanin altering or melanin reducing mutations like luteinos, albinos, white-faced luteinos, fallows. As albinos, there are no albinos in cockatiels, but you can say to differentiate they are white-faced luteinos. With luteinos, white-faced luteinos, fallows, dominant silver and recessive silver, and especially and more importantly, or I would say do not do it, that is pairing it up with cinnamon. Why? The reason would be, the question from your side, sorry, I would like to check the time again. The reason for that would be why we can do not pair it up with cinnamon. Because cinnamon will give it a more brownish tone, which is not good for a good emerald, because it destroys the emerald look, because emerald look is made with gray and yellow, not with chocolatey brown or brown and you can say yellow color. It is more with gray, tan gray and yellow color that makes up, or light gray and yellow color that makes up an emerald. So our normal emerald can look like a single factor dominant silver sometimes. Even it can have some of the things with it. Moreover, a white face emerald can look like a double factor dominant silver. Only the thing that would be differentiating is that the silver would be having slight tan gray silvery edges of the feathers or silvery tone that would help us to identify. But I would again say do not mix them up, because it can get very difficult to identify them even if you are an experienced person. I will make a video separately about the mutations of emerald and some of the pairing. So this was, I think, enough for explaining the emerald, and if I have missed out something, you can forgive me for that reason, because everything cannot be just summed up in a video, or I cannot remember everything. I tried my best to give you whatever I have, and I will make a second video related to the mutation of emeralds and some of the pairing results, and I would try to explain as much as it is possible for me. Thank you very much for watching this video. Inshallah, I will see you in next video. Allah Hafiz.